Hello friends, welcome back to virtual session, and today's session is extended session of swing. In last session we already had a discussion on detailed discussions on the swing, where we got various points related to advantages of swing over AWT. Then we discuss about how swing based components were lightweight as well as easy to better GUI or rich GUI features were available over there. So we constructed the frames and perform some events, handle some events on it. Now in today's session my agenda is it's a swing two session. First of all I'll be discussing how to add images on the swing based frame, right? How to add images, basically in our last session whatever the frames we constructed, that all frames were consist that label, text field and button. But if you want to add any image, let us understand you are constructing a login window and you want to have an image beside, login image beside that, then how you can add the image over there, right? So step number one, if you want to add the images onto the swing based frame, then step one, create a folder in your project step number one create a folder in your project by name images. It's always a better idea to store all the images in a related folder, right? So let us do it. Open a NetBeans, create a new project, pick up a location where you want to save it. Demo swing 2 is my project and I am going to store in the D: virtual session. And then you need to create the project. Now here in this project, what I said, I want to add a folder by the name of images because I have to deal with the images in this project. So right click on the project, click a select new and a folder and give it a suitable name. I am giving it right now images. So I am having a images as a folder which is going to have that all the images which I am going to use in the project, and finished it. Now friends, if you expand this project you will not find any images folder what you just recently added. Then what you need to do, you minimize this and go to physically to that folder where it is. It was D: the location and the project was virtual session. D: virtual session was the folder name. Then here this demo swing 2 was my project and there I found the images, right? Images as a folder over here. What I did, I created a project by the name of demo swing 2, then I add a folder by the name of images because I have to deal with the images. Friends, just try and understand one point, that while dealing with the images their absolute path and the relative path is very important. Path is very important while dealing with the images. So instead of keeping all the images anywhere else, We need to organize them better. For that reason, what I'm going to do, I need to create a folder by the name of images. As I said, when you expand this project, you will not find any, yeah, here it is, the image folder over here, right? So basically, while dealing with the project, for projects you will not get all the things are there, all the image folder available over here, right? If you go to the files, you will get it. But anyway, what you need to do now, you need to physically move to the location where you create the project, and there you find the images. Because here, what I am expecting to have a pictures or the images onto your swing base frames, we need to physically have the pictures. So I'm having a downloaded pictures, maybe logo of Exhum Tech Guru, and download .jpg. The logo of Exhum Tech Guru is a.png. You can right click on it and check the extension of it and download .jpg. Yeah? So these two pictures I'm dealing with now. So I'm physically copying this picture and paste to my images folder, right? Here. If you want to deal with the NetBeans directly, then you will select the files and then images, and here you can paste it also, right? And then now then you back to the project. Now what we did up till now, create a folder in your project by the name of images. Step 2, copy, select physical location of a folder and copy images files in it. Right? We need to physically go to that folder and copy whatever images you want to have on the swing base frames. You need to paste it over there. Right? Step number 2 is over. Now I need to do the coding over here. So for that reason, what I'm going to do, yeah, my project is dealing with images. So I'll edit my source code, import java.awt.star, import java.awt.event.star, and import javax.swing.star, right? Then public class demo swing 2 extends JFrame, right? And implements action listener. This is the common step what I'm going to perform. I want to extend my current class from JFrame. JFrame is a class belongs to Swing in our package called as Swing, and I'm going to process the events, that is button event, that is action listener over there. Then here you need to firstly declare all those components. That is, I'm reading J label, JLB1, right? And then I'll be reading initially as a first example. I just want to add only the images there. So what I will do, I will remove this action listener also. First of all, let us add the image firstly, right? So I will I just take a label JLB1, right? And then container CP. As you know, the components we need to add to the container over here. Then you define the constructor. Public. The constructor will be demo swing 2, and every frame need to have a title. So will my constructor have an argument as a title, and then once I get a call to the constructor, I'll be giving call to the super title. It means I will pass on this title to my swing based frame. Then my frame's size, I need to set it. Set size, specify the dimensions. I'll prefer 1200 as a width and height as a 800. Right? Then CP equals to the container equals to get contain pen. Now this step, whatever the size of your frame, right? This step is sets a size of a frame, and get contain pen will get the size of that particular frame, and container will also become of same size, right? Then CP dot set layout means by default there is a flow layout. As you are not adding the components onto the frame, you have to add the components onto the container. So it's a nullify the layout. As I said, your default layout is flow layout, but I don't want to have a flow layout. I want to add my visual components as per my own wish. So CP dot set layout null. Okay, and then here you need to, like, now here title you set, size you set, okay, and then get content pane layout null, then maybe set background you want to, and color dot any color you can specify, or you can even able to create the color also, that we'll discuss later on. So CP, like I said, you set the background color over here. After that, JLabel1, right, equal to new JLabel, right, and here I don't want to have a label actually. Label means it is useful for prompting message, but here in this case I don't want to set a label for prompting message, but I want to have an image on it. So what I will do, JLB equal to new JLabel, you pass on the image icon. New image icon, and then you specify the path of it. Path of image, actually, let's say image is having a file called as e.png. As you know, e.png is a logo of Exium Tech Guru, right? So let us say JLB1, and you assign JLB2 also, because I want to put a couple of images onto the my swing based frame. So JLabel1 will be initialized by the new image icon. Images, what is the path of that images, where I store all the images. Images slash, right, 2/ you have to use to separate the path, and a.png. In the similar manner, I'll initialize my second label. And now here I am saying my second name, second image name was download.jpg, right? So in this manner, my two images are initialized now. Now what I need to do, you need to set the bounds of it. Initialize label, then you need to set bounds of it, because as your label won't consist any data, it consists an image. So you, where you want to put that image, that you need to specify JLB1 dot set bounds. The X maybe you required, let us say you want to put it in the corner somewhere. So let's say 800 is X, Y you required 100, and the height you width you require, that is 300 maybe, or okay, and the width also you require, that is 300. or this is for the J label one. In the similar manner, you want to go with the, you want to select the location for the label two. Just try and understand here. Label I am using not for prompting any message, so no textual data is available on the label, but I want to use that label for having an images onto the swing best friend. So what I did, I initialize the jlabel object by new image icon and specify the path of it. So jlabel2.setBounds, I'm having, let's say, 400 as a x, right, and y will be I'll be going with a 600. Okay, let's say 400 also here, because your size y will be here, the 800 over here. So fine. Why not you go with the 1000 at least? So I'll select the y as a 1000. So for the height of the frame will be 1000 now. So I pick up 400, right, and then the size, like the total width of that image will be again 400, and height of the image again 400 over here. So I set the bounds of label 1 and label 2 in this panel, and then I need to add them. cp.add your jlb1, you need to add it, and cp.add jlb2, right? So I added all the like two labels over here. Labels I initialize with the image icons and then added that. And then as you know, like these dot set visible to make that make your frame visible, right? Makes the frame visible, right? And then you go to the main and create an instance of this demo swing to. New demo swing to and pass on the title, right? Demo swing to, maybe title. So once you create the instance of it, it gives a call to the constructor. Now whatever the title you pass on, demo swing to become a title of the frame. It sets the size of the frame as a 1200x and 1000y, right? So you get a frame of size 1200 will be the size of XX and Y will be the 1000. Get content till we get the size of it, and cp.setLayout will set the layout null and background color. These are the common steps to set the properties of a frame. Then my first primary agenda is to set the images onto the frame, so that I initialize label by the couple of images which I have already pasted in the folder called as images. Friends, what you need to do, you need to create a folder firstly by the name of images, because images need to be, because if you are unable to provide the specific path, images will not be appear. So images need to be organized in a better manner. Path is more important thing. So that's why instead of pasting the images directly into the source location or default location, I just create a package by the, I just create a folder by the name of images, and then I store that images on it, and then I set the bounds and then add the labels over there. Right? Let us cross check whether my project or my frame rather able to display the images properly or not. Right? So run the file and what you will find, yeah, here it is, the logo of the Exium Tech Guru as well as download.jpg. this is the download.jpg and this is the a.png. so any image, like it's not like these are the only images, any type of images means like it has to be supported of a GIF, graphical information format. So you can download any images from the net. You can download the images from your Facebook profile or any other images over there, and then to set or to have that images onto that visual components, like onto the frame, what you need to do, you need to initialize the label. What the first steps? What I used over here, or I follow over here. I created the folder by the name of images. I stored physically that images over there, right? And then I initialize my label, right? And then add that and set the bounds of that label, and then add them over there, right? Hope it is clear to you how to add this procedure is belong to how we can add images onto the now. As per the whatever the size of the image, that hardly matters, because you are customizing them, you are setting your own bounds. Are you getting it clear? So how much like size of the images you require onto the frame, you just create a label, set the, and then you can create the instance inside the like instance of image icon, and that image will be appear onto the frame, right? Hope you understand this is step one, right? So this particular code will help you out how we can able to put an images onto the swing page frame. Now the next thing what I want to like explain you that okay, now this is frame number one, but from this frame I want to navigate from this frame to another frame, right? I want to navigate from this frame one to another frame, then what I have to do, right? Let us like discuss that, navigating from one frame to another frame, right? So if you want to navigate from one frame to another frame, obviously you will be, let us say, means if you hit on the button, you can navigate to the next, and if you hit on the another frame's button, you can revert back to the original frame. So I'll be implements action listener, right? And I'll be adding let's say button, J button, J BT1. Now I'm in the frame called as demo swing 2, right? And if I click on the button, that button may be referring to the reference of next frame, right? So JBT1 navigating is useful for navigating to another frame, right? So what I will do to navigate to another frame, at least I need to create another frame also, right? So I will be adding a new Java class, maybe frame 2, my frame 2, right? And this is second frame, right? And I'll create this frame, public class my frame, extends J frame, implements action listener, right? And for that reason you need to import the packages, that is import java.awt.start, import java.awt.event.start, and import javax.swing.start. So these packages I imported, and I'm having a my class which extend from JFrame implements action listener. Let us do the coding for this. Means I need to construct another frame. Let us say like all frames are individually separate. They can run individually. But whenever you are dealing with a project, you need to navigate from one frame to another frame. Means you have to link up that all the frames together, right? So let us firstly, first frame we already designed, that is swing demo, right? 2. And then I'm having a second frame by the name of my frame 2. And I first of all, I will separately individually run them, and then I will establish the link between them so that I can switch from frame 1 to another frame, and frame 2 to another, back to the revert back to the same frame over there. So public class, my frame to extend JFrame implements action listener. I am having a button, right? And I'll be having a label also. Okay. Here, B has to be capital J. Yes, I'm having two components: label and button. And then container, and then you will define the constructor. Mistakes are common now. Public then super title. Set the title of the frame, then this dot set size, set the size of the frame, then cp equals to get content pen, we get the size of the frame, then cp dot set layout, that is null, which nullify the layout. Cp dot set background, we can wait for not set bounds, it's set background. Set background color, and you can specify the color. As I said in the prior discussion, that we can create your own color code. Why not you create your own color code? Color C1 equals to new color. And you provide here the RGB values, right? Let's say you say like 250, 250, maybe 150, right? Let's say RGB combinations, and then here you can pass on that color offset. So this is the RGB combination, red, green, and blue, you know, that. Like you have to specify, and in that way you can instead of directly specify the color, you can create your own customized color. If you want to know about this RGB, you can go to W3 schools you can understand about what is the RGB combination to create various color codes. Anyway, cp dot set background, I'll set the background with that customized color code, and then what I'm going to do now, I need to initialize my label. So again, if you want to have an image out for this label, so jlb1 equal to new jlabel, new image icon, and you pass on this like the images slash e.png. This is the second frame. I'm putting the image again, and then jbt1 equal to new j button, and I'm having the text like a previous, and I'll set a font type equals to new font, a real font I'm using with a bold as a style, and 20 I require, and jpt1 dot set font f. Okay, so like now I need to set the bounds of it. So jlb1 dot set bounds for the bounce of that like particular image where you want to appear, that you would have set, let's say 800, and 100 is something, y over here, and then 300 is a position of that particular logo, and then jbt1 dot set bounce, that bounce, but where you need to require a button, 400 x, maybe again 500 y, and you have the width of that button will be maybe 150 and height will be 30, right? And now like you initialize the button, you initialize the like label with the icon, and then now cp.add jlb1 as well as cp.add jbutton1, and then this dot make that frame visible, set visible true, and then you need to create a main method, public static void when string args, and you create the instance of my frame too. As I said, you have to individually run the frame firstly, and you have to equals to new you can create the instance, or you can create anonymous instance, that's not a problem. But now if I run the frame, now I should get the second frame's result like this. Okay, but like the problem is we are having an action listener and we yet to process that, so I'll write public void action performed and action event A, right? And here before adding the button, jbt1 dot add action listener, this, right? So now I'm not adding any event handler right now, but let's run the code to get a GUI. Okay, let us say your demo swing 2, it consists some errors, implement section listener. Okay, actually you added button, but you yet not process the event of it. So right now let us see. Okay, are you button we already added, we'll write the code over here, public void action performed as if you are implementing an interface. If you are implementing an interface, you must overwrite the method, right? Otherwise it will throw the error. That was the error over there. Anyway, now this is individually my frame, first frame, and individually this is my second frame, right? And here is a button for previous. Obviously I'll be writing a button for next in the my demo swing 2, frame 1. Now look at the color code of frame 2, right? It's like customized color code I am getting over here, right? Anyway, now my frame 1 and frame 2 are individually, I am getting an interface. I haven't deliberately designed the beautiful interface because I don't have any objective. My objective was just to how to add images onto the swing based frame, and the second objective I am trying to perform now, how I can able to navigate from frame 1 to frame 2. Fine. So I'll go to the frame firstly, and then I need to add the button so that I can go to the navigate to the frame 2. So okay. I will add the font f equals to new font Arial, and the font and the size of it. And then I'll be adding a button, jbt1 equals to new jbutton, and the button is the next, and j button 1 dot set font, that is f, then j button 1 dot add action listener, this start listening the action, and then I'll add the button as well. But where is the bounce of it? So that you need to set up where you need the button. So let's say jbt1 dot set bounce. I need a button maybe somewhere. Okay, you got a 400 400. Okay, so you go with the 400, but x. So you like x will be 100, y will be 500. Okay, but 400 you are starting from here. Okay, fine enough. You like okay 200, and width will be 150, and 30 will be the size of it. These are the bounds of your button 1, and then it added. If any action performed on the button, then if the source of a dot get source, if the button what you which you hit having is referring to the object jbt1, then what you have to do, you have to navigate to the frame 2, right? So while navigate to the frame 2, you just need to create the instance of frame 2 over here. That's it, right? You will be directly move to the frame 2, the instance of frame 2 will be created over there. And then whenever you are in the frame 2, okay, bounce dot set, okay, fine. Then if a dot get source equals to j button 1, then you create the instance of frame create the instance of frame 1, right? So if you are in the frame 1, if you hit on the button called as next, you will be moved to the frame 2. And if you are in the frame 2, and if you hit the button that is by the title of previous, then obviously you will be reached back to the original frame. Let us compile this. Some error to be sure. Let us see what the error is. Okay. We have label continue button, font. Okay. We set the font, you set the button by the name of next. Okay, and then set the font, add action listener, then set the bounds of it and add the button, right? Perfect. And we have action performed, my frame 2, yes, my frame 2 was not available over here, so I added my frame 2 in a different folder. Anyway, I will make a copy of this and store it to the source folder. Actually, my frame 2 need to be added. Okay, I'll just do one thing. Actually, my frame 2 is not visible to the class over there. Anyway, why not we copy at least. Can we copy this? Paste to this. Yes. And you can delete this. So demo swing 2 import not required this, and then yeah, so no import required now, right? And second this. Now this is my frame 1. If I click on the next, I'll be able to move to the next frame. If I click on the previous, I'll be able to go first frame. Right? So, yeah, what I did here that I firstly created my project by the name of Demo Swing 2, and in that Demo Swing 2, I explained you how we can add the images, right? While adding the images, you have to create the instance of label, and by new image icon you have to add them, and then obviously set the bounds and all, right? Now what my next assignment was, how we can able to navigate from one frame to another frame, right? So for that reason, what I did, I'm having frame 1, I'm having frame 2, these individual 2 frames are running over here. So I create a next button. Obviously both the frames has to be the same package, right? Like what I did over here, I create a button called as next to the frame 1, and I create a button as a previous in the target frame, right? And then when you hit on the next button of frame 1, you need to create the instance of frame 2, so you can able to navigate to the frame 2. And if you want to go to the previous again, you can have a previous over here. So in this manner, you can able to create the frame navigator, right? It's like here two things we understand quickly. That is, understand better. That is how we can add images onto swing based frame. That is point number 1. Second, how we can establish navigator from one frame to another frame over there, right? How to set the navigators? Have the two buttons in the. Now just try and understand that in your project, as per the presentation layer, you have to define. You have to create various frames. Every frame may be individual enough. Why I'm saying every frame may be individual enough? Because every frame have a mem, and you can run them, right? And now, if you want to establish the link between them, then in the source frame, I should have a button, right? If you hit on that, you should be able to navigate to the target frame. From the target frame, you can switch, revert back to the one frame. So not only navigate between the two frames, but multi frames can be, you can able to establish navigation between them. So this is the elementary discussions what I'm doing with the navigating through frames over here, right? Now two things we get clear up till now, how to add the images, and second is how to navigate from source frame to target, or navigation through frames. Right? How to navigate through frames? Okay, you should have the buttons, and then if you click on the button, you should create the instance of the another frame, and in this manner you can navigate. Now, one more thing I just want to demonstrate to you in today's session, that is, like, we by using swing components, we are constructing GUI, and that GUI is called as presentation layer. But you know that if you observe the code, right, to define the presentation layer, it is we need to write a lot of code over here. But there is no alternative for this. We have to develop a presentation layer in this manner. But while developing, means like we always need to, what you need to do, you separate your presentation layer with the application layer. Now, application layer means the processing logic GUI will give you the presentation layer, but the application logic, you need to write it separately, right? And that too in the OOP format. So if you write your, up till now we understand that, why OOP? Because OOP provides data security, encapsulations, inheritance, reusability, right? One thing used for many reasons, that is called the polymorphisms, abstractions, and to have these all the features, your application logic, just try and understand. If a problem is given to me, then what GUI is required, that is I'm going to design through swing. But like after hit of the button or after processing the event, what logic, what data processor processing logic I want to write, that I will separate out from the swing based frame, otherwise it become a lengthy code, right? And the logic I may need repeatedly in the another frames as well. So today let us discuss one small example, how the GUI and the application logic I should able to separate it over there. And so for that, for demonstrating this, what I'm going to do, I'll be creating another class by the name of GUI, right? And here I'll create a GUI to read a number to find factorial, let's say, simple, right? And import java.awt.star, import java.awt.event.star and import javax.swing.star. I'll firstly create the interface for reading a number from the user, right? And then after reading that number, to find the factorial of it, I will require the logic of it, and that logic I will not write in the presentation layer. I will separate it out, right? So I'm just by giving simple example, just like let us understand, if you want to read a number and find a factorial, so what you will do, what you'll be doing, you'll be creating a GUI, you'll be adding the logic of factorial there and there only, so it become a lengthy code. So instead of that, why not you separate out the logic for finding factorial, that is, you may write the class factorial and then methods to find a factorial, and then in the presentation layer you accept the data and pass on that data. So this is what I'm trying to explain to you. Okay, so public class GUI extends JFrame, implements action listener, right? And then declaration of components, JLabel. Now how much table you required, JLB1, the title of it, okay? Yeah, and then enter a number, and this is the result of it. These three labels are required. And how much text field you required? Okay, here it is, like text field 1, then text field 2 for reading a number, and you got the result over here. And the next thing what you require, that is called as J button. That is JBT1 for finding factorial, and JBT2 for refreshing the data, right? Here you required a B as a capital over here, right? Okay, so we have a label for the prompting message. Then we have prompting message of enter a number, and then the result text field, and the two buttons are required over here. Why two buttons? One is for finding factorial, second is for refreshing the data available. Okay, now I need to define the constructor. Again, I will set the properties of the that frame. The similar steps we have to follow all the time now. Here you got a container. Then cp dot set layout to null, cp dot set background to whichever color you need. And then initialize the JLB1 equal to JLB. Factorial is a title. You can set the font. JLB1, then you got a second label with the title enter a number, and just with a small one. And then we have a result. Right? And then you add the fonts, or you go with the text fields also. JTF1 equals to new JTX field. Second, and then you got a new button also, JBT1 equal to new J button, which is for factorial, and J button 2 is for refresh the data. Okay, and then JLB1 dot set font f, you copy it for all, let's say label 1, label 2, label 3, Xpeed 1. Xpeed 2. As well as 1. Button 2 as well. Okay. And then set the bounds. JLB1 dot set bounds. Let's say 400 of 100, comma 250 of 30. Then JLB2 dot set bounds, that is maybe 200 of 200 and 250 of 30, and then JLB3 and then again 200 of 300 and 250 of 300, and then you got a text field JTF1 dot set bounds. That is 200 to 500, comma 200, comma 250, comma 30, because you need to need adjacent one, right? And then here get text field 2, you required again 500 of 300 and 250 and something, and the button you required J button 1 dot set bounds, right? You required a 400 of maybe 400 and 200 of 30, and then you need an adjacent one, so J button 2 650 of 400 and 230, huh? And then cp.add JLB1, you need to add all the components, JLB2, JLB3, text field 1, text field 2, button 1, and button 2, right? And then before adding that buttons, you have to add jbt1 dot add action listener, this, and jbutton 2 dot add action listener, this, right? And then as you are adding action listener, you complete the constructor before this dot set visible to, right? And then we override public void action performed, action event A, right? And then you have a main method also as well, public static void main string args, and you need to create the instance of GUI. Let us like test the GUI firstly, and then we'll add the okay. Some of the problems may be there. Yeah, here it is. factorial, enter a number and result, everything is there, buttons are there. Okay, fine. But now if a dot get source equals to bt1 button 1, so you need to read the number and n equals to integer dot parse integer of jtf1 dot get text, you get the text of and now you are not supposed to write the processing logic over here, right? And then else if a dot, let me complete the code firstly. A dot get source equals to jbt2, then obvious jtf1 dot set text, that is null, and because I have to make it a refresh it, and then jtf2 dot set text also null. What I'm going to explain to you now, okay, why not you add a package, right? This package consists that application logic, yes? Maybe by the name of mypk is a package name, right? And in that my package, I'm going to add a public class by the name of factor. Okay, just understand your class has to be factor, and then here I'm going to write the public static find factor method, which requires a number as an argument, right? And then I'm going to define the factorial logic, intf equals to 1 while n more than 0, f into equals to n, n minus minus, and return the value of f. Public static integer find factor means find factor is a method which requires integer arguments, it returns integer, and it's a static method defined in the code as find factor, defined in the class code as factor. And factor is a class which actually belongs to a package called as mypk. Means here I'm deliberately trying to distinguish, separate out this GUI logic from the application logic. So what I need to do here to find the factorial, I have to import a package called as mypk dot factor, was a class available here. Now here once I get the data from the user, what I will write, intf equals to, right? Now like factor class having a method called as find factor, and I will pass it on this n as an argument, right? So call to find factor is a method not belong to my current presentation layer, it belong to the different packages. So that the application logic I'm going to separate it, I wrote separately in the individual separate package. So it evaluates the factorial of the number stored in f, and then jtf dot 2 dot set text, right? And then f, the value of factorial, and then here I'll forcefully convert into the string over here. And now if you run this particular project, what you will find, okay, main GUI, I believe somewhere opening closing issues are there. Anyway, this is okay. Then yeah, this end of constructor. Then public void action performed. This end of action performed. Okay. And then there is another required, that is end of class. Right. because class also need to be end, so here so, okay, let us try this. GUI won't consist main method or something. Anyway, yeah, probably submit on the line. Oh, it's end of class. Should not be there. Okay, fine. It's a misplace of this thing. Okay. Now you run it, you will get the result. Yeah, here if you enter any number, you are able to find the factorial of it and refresh it. If you, alright. Now you will say, what's new in this? It's nothing new actually, but like here I try to demonstrate you that don't try to mingle up the GUI presentation layer and application layer together, because it's already the lengthy code. So it requires much more focus and concentration to build these things, and if you not able to separate out the application, because here I just try to demonstrate the code of finding factorial only, but like while resolving the bigger problems and the projects, you may consist n number of processes involved in the presentation layer, and that need to be processed, and in such situations it's better idea you may have the link up of many frames, you may have the many classes which is going to process the data. So in such situation it's always better to create your own package as well as import that library into the presentation layer there. Hope you understand it, right? My motive is to how to add the images, how to navigate from one frame to another frame, and how to separate out the GUI presentation layer from the application layer, right? Hope you got everything clear about this all topics what I tried to cover it in this video sessions, right? Thank you.